Do we have people on Zoom?
Yeah. And I don't know who this summer is.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We have a reminder to the women of the church that this Tuesday, the lunch is at 4:01 at 1 o'clock. Welcome to our church service today. We hope you find it inspiring and meaningful for you, as well as joyful and uplifting. Welcome to our neighbors and to all of you. Of all places you could be on a Sunday morning, why are you here? We come to celebrate the presence of the one who knows our hearts and guides our choices. Eternal life, starting here, starting now. Gus, will you please do connections?
Couple verses that I found. One in particular.
Jesus said, above all, love each other deeply. Because love covers a multitude of sins, offer hostility to each other without grumbling.
No.
Each of you should give whatever gift you have received to serve as others, as faithful servants of God. If anyone speaks, they should do so as everyone who speaks the word of God. If anyone serves, they should do so with the spirit of sacrifice, so that in all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ. To him be the glory and the power forever and ever. So, we talk about helping each other. Jesus is teaching and working with the city. Adam. Adam was the first for a little while, and God realized, God didn't want us to be alone from the beginning. He wanted us to be with other people in the community. So in the early days, when people first started meeting in church, and they didn't have any friends, I guess, their church would be, they would be in homes, and they would have meals together. And we talk about Jesus and what he was teaching. And in our very early church communities, nobody needed anything. That was the job of the community. People really took care of each other. If their neighbors needed food, church community comes through to help out. Safe Center. And there is a person from the Safe Center here today that's going to tell us all about the Safe Center. But that is a place where people can go, they need help, and they need items that, like toilet paper, like children, like clothes, and they can get them for free from the Safe Center. So, this is part of what Jesus has been teaching us, right? We help others, people who need. We're so fortunate. We pretty much have everything we need, most of us. And if not, someone in our church can help us, or someone in our neighborhood. But our church community does this. We ask people in this, okay, just turn around and put all these people in the church. They bought all of this stuff for people we don't even know. But we knew there was a need. And we just wanted us to help others and give to others in need, right? So, to wrap this up, we're going to say a little prayer. And then, as a thank you to all of the people in our church who brought all this stuff for the Safe Center, I have a little treat, bags of candy. So, we're going to pass out a little treat as a thank you to all of the members of our church.
Thank you.
And Ken will now do our first scripture reading. Well, he does, but not on this song. And continuing on, we have John 15:12-13, pronounced that my command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. Psalms 133:1 reveals, behold how good and pleasant it is when brothers
brothers dwell in unity. And in Peter 4, 8 to 10, it is indicated that above all, keep loving one another earnestly, since love covers a multitude of sins. Show hospitality to one another without grumbling, as each has received a gift. Use it to serve one another as good stewards of God's very grace. And now we'll do Amazing Grace. We'll call up the piano.
Thank you. program in Stella's Famous Stewardship Program says, the next 2 minutes is on time and now. I'm going to be out of here in 2 minutes. I'm going to talk about one gig in Time and Town, and I'm going to have you pre-qualify for that gig, okay? 3 steps. Big smile. Everybody smile. Wide grin. Big grin, okay? Now, wave. Wave. You're on the top of the steps out here before us. Welcome to Congregational Church. Welcome to Congregational Church. That's it.
Thank you.
from the Safe Center, and she's very graciously agreed to come speak to us. Her name is Kristen Gilpin. Please give her a warm welcome.
Good morning. Thank you so much for inviting me to speak a little bit about Safe Center. Like it was mentioned, my name is Kristen Gilpin, and I'm the program director at Safe Center. Safe Center is a domestic and sexual violence agency. We are located in Shiawassee in Clinton County, and our shelter is located here in Owosso. Our mission is to empower, advocate, educate, and prevent. Safe Center provides a variety of free and confidential services for children and adult survivors of domestic and sexual violence. We are a small but mighty team, and our work never stops. As a 24/7, 365-day operation, we are always open and available and ready to help those in need. Some of the services that we offer is a 24-hour crisis line. Like I mentioned, we have an emergency shelter. We do information and referrals. We have individual counseling and advocacy. We also do legal advocacy, which includes court support and personal protection order assistance. We have a housing program and assistance with that. We also have a sexual assault therapist on staff. My staff also does on-call emergency response to the hospital and police departments when needed. And we also offer support groups. Some numbers from last year that Safe Center provided to our clients. We served 70 individuals for emergency shelter. We served 32 clients and their families in our transitional housing program. And we served 341 individuals across all of our programs. October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month, and it's a very busy time for us at Safe Center. We have a lot of activities going on. One in particular that I would like to mention is that we'll be having a candlelight vigil on Tuesday, October 17th from 5:30 to 6:30 at Shiawassee County Historical Courthouse in downtown Corona. And I would just like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for supporting us, because without that, we could not provide the services that we do to our survivors. It was a pleasure being able to share with you all of the work and services that Safe Center provides. Thank you again for letting me come and speak this morning.
It's a complicated day. We have a pastor who deserves to be honored, but is embarrassed when the focus is on her. Her natural gift of being humble and kind is one of the many reasons she is so loved by our congregation. Our community team has worked on this service for more than 6 months. We are well aware that Pastor Deb would be happiest if we did something for another cause instead of for her. So we did. That is when the idea of helping the Safe Center came into our hearts. Pastor Deb is a warrior for others. As Kristen said, the Safe Center focuses on creating pathways to safety and gives survivors opportunities to heal. Our congregation began collecting items for the Safe Center throughout August and September. Letters were sent to the congregation inviting them to donate items and monetary gifts to the Safe Center, but no pressure was placed upon anyone to give. The surprise arrives here and now. Our congregation as one has donated $1,600 in Pastor Deb's honor and name to be given to the Safe Center on this date, October 8th, 2023.
I'd like to share a little story if I may, and this just is something that happened to me that made me realize how important the Safe Center is to our community. Just bear with me, it's a little long, but I appreciate it. I was a kindergarten teacher, as many of you know, the best job in the world, and several years ago, I woke up one spring morning, it was late in the spring, April or May, and it was cold, it was raining, the rain was pelting on it, it was Friday, and I was just teacher tired, thinking, oh God, please make it a Saturday morning. Well, of course, that was going to happen, so I'll make it through the day. I got to school, and I was talking with my teaching partner, who was a heaven sent person. I'll call her Miss Susie for the story. We were commiserating how the gloomy day was, how gloomy the day was, and how we were just going to get through our Friday. And all of a sudden, our breakfast arrived. We served breakfast in the morning. We opened the toast. Our favorite breakfast, chocolate chip muffins with chocolate milk and apple thrown in for good measure. Well, 27 kindergartners and chocolate muffins are a recipe for a disaster on top of a rainy day with no recess. And so we were just laughing, passing out breakfast, and all of a sudden there's a knock on the door, and it's a secretary, and she's got this little beautiful brown-eyed boy staying with her, and she goes, "Good morning, Mrs. Sawyer, you have a new student." And I said, "Today?" Because typically, as any educator knows, the protocol is you have at least a day's advance notice just because you want to get ready. Name tags ready, supplies ready, where they're going to sit, what group they're going to get. I mean, there's a million things that go into it. And you want, most of all, you want to feel welcome, not just like they're walking in to a place and nobody is happy they're there. So I was, "Oh, hi, Joey, welcome." And she said, "Well, Mom talked to Mom." And is pretty insistent he stay. And I said, "Oh, okay." So, kind of side-eyed with Susie, and we're doing the best we can. And I said, "Oh, let's go hang things up." And we went to his hook and hung his little jacket up with his sweatshirt. And it's cold, rainy, and windy. And I said, "Do you have a backpack, Joey?" And he goes, "I didn't bring it." And I said, "Oh." And mind you, they had just arrived the day before to their new home. So they arrived on Thursday, he's there Friday, and I said, did you bring it? "No, I didn't bring it." I said, "Oh, did you leave it in your car?" "I didn't bring it." "Did you leave it at your new house?" "I didn't bring it." I said, "Okay, we'll go in and we'll find your backpack." And so we found it. He picked out a Ninja Turtle backpack, and he went for the chocolate muffins, and they're the oldest Funkmeyer, whatever, about the size of a small child's head. These are huge muffins. And I said, "Come on, an apple." It was just a few minutes before the other kids were coming, so he grabbed an apple, and I said, "Well, let's walk around the room, and I'll show you some things." And he's, touching everything, opening all the cupboard doors. And kindergarten rooms have a lot of stuff, and he was touching everything. And I was asking him some questions. I said, "What's your favorite thing about school, Joey?" He goes, "Recess." And I said, "Well, maybe we can do that another day." And then we were talking, and he was touching things, going all around, and I said, "What else do you like to do?" He said, "Movies." We don't really watch too many movies in our kindergarten class. So the other children arrived, and they're sitting down, getting ready. They all know what to do, and they're getting ready to put Joey between two of the perfect children so they could help him. And I showed Joey how you open your milk. I was a little detail. You open the milk with the strong closes, so if it tips over, just it dribbles out. Well, I'm helping the other children get Joey all settled, helping, and all of a sudden I see a flash across the room under the table. And I look, and Joey's gone, and here's this milk all over his table. And the kids are, "Spill it, table four, spill it, table four." And they're all scrambling and they're helping and the Susie's helping and I went over to little Joey under the table and I'm like, Joey, what's wrong? And he's, you know, crying, I spilled, I'm sorry, I'll clean it up. I said, it's okay, come on, it's okay, you're fine. So coaxed him out, we got back. And it was just a morning that you commanded for your little kindergartner, you know, room with lots of people. And Miss Susie sat with him, he was up and down, under chairs, over chairs. We got his new supplies ready for him. The teacher is cutting his tool bag, teacher, he's bringing his crayons. And it just, that's how the morning progressed. Well, lunchtime came, we thought, okay, it's fun Friday. We have an art project, we have centers, we have special class. We'll be great, we'll fly through. So he goes to lunch, tips his tray, gets a new tray, that was all fine. And then special comes, he goes to music, that's a good one, he can settle in. So Miss Susie sits with them and then she comes back and she comes back to the room and Joey's down there. She's there for maybe approximately 3 minutes and the phone rings and I look at her and she looks at me and she goes, don't answer that. You know, it was the music teacher calling. So I answered, and she goes, can Miss Susie possibly come back? And I said, well, we'll come again, Joey. So we brought Joey back. I said, Emergency's a little calm, away from all the action. And he liked books. He liked animals. So we sat down with Joey. We were talking with him, trying to do some informal assessment. By this time, we knew we could write his name. And it's April or May in kindergarten. We could write his name. He knew a couple of letters, not really many sounds. You know, so we had a lot of work to do in the next few weeks. And so at the end of, while we're talking with Joey, I said, Joey, do you have any brothers or sisters? And he goes, yeah, I have 2 brothers and my mom has a baby in the belly. And I thought, oh, okay. So, you know, by the end of the day, I mean, Joey's mom picked him up a little bit early, not much, but a little bit early. We did end up watching a movie. And so we got through it. And like I said, lots of up and down under tables, just busy boy. And Miss Susie and I just looked at each other, ooh, okay. She left a little bit before I did. And so the children are gone. I look at the clock, it's 4:15. And I really wanted to touch base with my principal because that principal knew a lot about what had happened and wasn't available during the day. So I looked at the clock, I thought, I can't wait 20 minutes, I need to go. So I thought, I'll come in the weekend, clean everything up, get ready for the next week, and I will talk to my principal early Monday morning. So I'm leaving school. I usually go to Mallory Street, 52, we live north of town, and there's a police that has somebody pulled over, so I turned down Mallory Street, which was Hickory Street. And I'm driving, it's still raining, like crazy, it's cold, it's blowing, and I'm thinking, what kind of parent brings their child to school in a random town, random home, everything brand new just drops them off? What kind of parent doesn't have everything ready for them? Because, I mean, the backpack's pretty basic supply. What kind of parent, just thinking all these things? And I get down Hickory Street, and I see somebody pushing a stroller. And it's raining hard, and my vapors aren't going because it was raining so hard. And I thought, oh, I get it closer. It's a double stroller with one umbrella. And then I get closer and I see a little Ninja Turtle backpack. And it's Joey and his mom walking. And suddenly, that parent that I had been under, you know, in my mind thinking questionable things with throughout the course of the day, that parent suddenly became my hero. Because I thought, during the day, I thought, who would do this to their child? This wasn't best for him. She was doing what was best for him. You know, she, at all costs, took those children, went to the SAFE Center, and that's where they turned in. And so I just developed such a respect for her and everything that she had done. And we helped little Joey for the rest of the year, and then their family moved on. I don't know who they are, of course, but it was such a learning thing for me, but it just brought real light to wonderful work that happens and the wonderful refuge that these people have at the SAFE Center. So I guess I hope that helps you understand a little bit more about what actually goes on behind those doors, because it sure did for me. So in honor of Pastor Deb, in all the wonderful things, generosity from our congregation, we thank you, and for all the Joeys and their mamas, we hope it helps.
Next to come up is Gus and Esther Gooden. This is, I know, this is all order, isn't it? This is for you. This shows the amount that was given to the Safe Center for you. Plus, there was two other checks that were given right to the Safe Center from members of our congregation. And that is your remembrance and your thank you for all that you do for this community.
The best gift you guys
ever had.
Something to give to Pastor Doug, but really, for it's from all of us. So, I know, I said on my own, but I said, we should give this to me like 3 weeks ago. So, we all talked about today and how much Deb does not like to really be thanked, right? She doesn't like to be acknowledged for the things that she has done. But as a new member of this congregation, I can tell you that she does so much for all of us every single day, and the love. And so we wanted to present some thank yous for everything you have done for all of us. And if you did not write your thank you, and there are more cards in the back that can be added to this, so that Deb has a collection of those days when she's having a really hard day, she can look back and say, this is why I do what I do, because we love her and she is amazing. So this is for you.
And thanks to Kara and Amanda. there's one more surprise.
Oh. talking about.